Tracy, I thought you was proven, but you're not through yet.
One more case.
Okay, would you do, please present VA-2016-02, City of Valdosta text amendments.
We have three text amendments to the land development regulations. It's a relatively new document, it's a living document. We adopted it in 2008, became effective in 2009. As we have utilized it over the past few years, we found a few little things that just aren't working or need to be tweaked a little bit. The first one, the LDR enacted a minimum parking requirement and a maximum parking requirement. The maximum parking requirement being 125% of what the minimum is. We've had some issues with some smaller commercial centers that may only require 5, 6, 8, 10, a small amount of parking spaces, but they'd like to have maybe 12 or 15, which isn't a Walmart or big box retailer parking space requirement. However, their only options for adding those couple of extra above the maximum parking space would be either through administrative variance or through ZBOA variance. So we'd like to remove the maximum cap. The second one, we've had some discussion in this economy. We have a 6-month non-conforming rule. In theory, if you have, and I'm using this as an example, not to point at a particular situation, if you have a commercial shop in a residential area, maybe it's a commercial, a little commercial barber shop or something, standalone barber shop in the middle of a residential area. If it goes out of business for at least 6 months, it can't go back in unless it's rezoned. We've heard some concerns about extending that time period from 6 months to 12 months. So this is what that alteration is recommending, to change the non-conforming status from 6 months to 12 months. The third recommendation is from our stormwater management folks to tweak some of their regulations to make some deletions. Any questions?
So I'm curious on that. It was 6 months, now you've extended to 12 months. So is that a building is literally vacant? It could be vacant up to 12 months in the business and then go right back in?
Yes, sir.
I have a question.
Mr. Gladden?
Tracy, how many cases about the parking criteria? How many cases a year or a month? Let's say a month. Would you say you have that they are asking for more parking for additional parking that they have to go through the process?
We have had very few people who actually go through the process. Most are deterred at the idea of having to apply for a couple of extra parking spaces. So most do not go through the administrative variance or zoning board of appeals variance.
So what do they do in practicality? Do they just build a non-conforming parking lot, or do they just accept it?
They accept it, or they find an alternative location.
Because I find that criteria to remove the park maximum cap to be particularly not environmentally friendly.
Right.
And it bothers me to see that for very few we are going to be taking that away. So I would strongly recommend denial of that one amendment. And I don't know why we would even be. It really needs not to be considered. We are a city that takes pride in our natural landscape. We have a very strong tree ordinance. It might be criticized at times, but in any case, we need to promote environmentally friendly, and we need to be aware of that. So I really think that's not. If the request is so minimal,
right.
I really don't see how that can be justified.
Right.
The others, I don't see any issue with the other two amendments.
Which one would you object to?
Amendment one, Mr. Raker. One of the first ones. Amendment number one about parking.
Oh, okay, up here. I was looking at the red letter.
No, I would just simply.
Well, it is the red letter, but you can just need to go number one.
So you're talking about all three of those paragraphs?
Yes, I think it needs to be maintained, and I think
you want to unstrike it.
I want to unstrike it. It needs to remain as is.
Take it out of red.
Take it out of red, keep it brown as is.
That would be all three paragraphs.
Correct, yes.
Any other questions or comments for Tracy on this?
Can we remove just one of these and vote on the other two, or does it have to go through as an entire?
You can recommend approval of one, you can recommend approval of two, you can recommend approval of all three.
Any other questions or comments for staff? Anything amongst ourselves on this, commissioners? Anybody here wishing to speak in favor of this request, please come forward at this time. Clayton's jumping up and down back there trying to get up here.
Didn't know where we were going to finish.
My name is Clayton Milligan. I'm trying not to extend this meeting any longer than it needs to be.
Bless you.
3998 Interpreter Road. Again, I work with Level Engineering, so I work with these regulations quite a bit. I would like to request that first one stay in, and my reasoning behind that is there's already an impervious area maximum in place within the code. But there's already an impervious area that we cannot exceed, no matter what parking. During the current code, we've run into this a couple of times, there may be a limit on the number of parking spaces we could provide, but the code would allow you to go in right next to there and build a basketball court. That would be the same impervious area as that parking lot would be. So I would recommend we'd be in favor of that change of not having a maximum parking number and just letting the impervious area maximum govern how much of that lot you can pay for the parking lot.
Okay, Clayton, stand right there. Right. Any questions for our presenter?
Yes.
Commissioner Glad.
So there's right now there is a sort of a redundancy, what you're saying, between the parking criteria and the impervious surface criteria.
Correct.
And to kind of piggyback off of what Clayton's saying, Clayton is correct in the sense that our commercial districts, going from residential professional on up, your impervious cap ranges from 70% to 75%.
So in general, what is more stringent? Is it the parking criteria or the impervious surface criteria?
The parking criteria for the parking lot is more stringent. So oftentimes we could still be under the 75%, but the parking criteria limits the size of that parking lot, even though we could still add 2, 3, 4 more spaces and still be well under that.
So what you're saying, you can add a building.
You can add a building, you can add a paved.
Because of the impervious.
Right, and still be under the impervious area, mm-hmm. But the parking regs would not allow those extra spaces.
Any other questions for our presenter?
So you're saying if you remove the parking restriction, we'd be dealing just with the impervious, the part that you're paving over, whether you use it for the basketball court or whether you use it for parking lots. But there would be no requirement for the number of parking spaces.
We would still have a minimum requirement for parking.
We will still have the
minimum. Yes, there would still be a minimum requirement. So you still have a minimum required number of parking spaces that you have. Often developers want to add more. And just let that impervious area max, that impervious area cap, govern how much more they can add. Which, what the amendment that they're requesting effectively does that.
Okay.
Any other questions for our presenter?
I don't have questions.
Thank you, Clayton. Anybody else here wishing to speak in favor of this request? There being none, anybody here wishing to speak in denial of this request for the text amendments? Anybody here wishing to speak in denial?
No, I'm just saying.
Yes, ma'am.
My name is Sandra Tooley. I live at 304 South Street here in Valdosta, Georgia. And I request it now because number three, I heard and said that there were some tweaks to the stormwater. They want to tweak a few things to the stormwater, but I was not sure. Did she say what they were? What we're going to do with it?
Tracy, would you mind going back over that again?
Sure. They are taking away, there are differentiations. I'm sorry, I have technical problems pronouncing that word. In developments of more than 5,000 square feet, of impervious area, and those that are less than 5,000 square feet are handled a little bit differently. This amendment will take away that distinction to handle stormwater, that stormwater runoff rates, volumes, and velocities. They can't be made any worse by development than they were before development.
Same as the back of the subdivision, okay, I'm gonna just try to trace some out of here all of that.
This is commercialism, is that what you're getting at, Tracy, or?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you, my question is not quite answered, but it's not, okay, I just need a little more information, okay, I just wasn't sure, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Anybody here else wishing to speak in denial of this request, please come forward. There being none, commissioners, any more discussion amongst ourselves on this? There being none, I will take a motion on these three text amendments individually or collectively.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to make a motion that we recommend the City Council that approval of all three conditions, find the consistent with the comprehensive plan. As was pointed out, the deletion of the parking lot requirement maximum will be covered by the other environmental concerns for maximum development. And for the stormwater management situation, basically the answer there for the lady who had the question, Ms. Cooley, I believe, is what it's basically saying is regardless of whether or not a development is more than or less than 5,000 square feet, whatever happens shall not make stormwater runoff any worse than it is as existing before the development. So that's my motion.
Thank you, Commissioner Wiles, for the motion and the clarification. So we have a motion from Commissioner Wiles. Do we have a second on that motion?
No, second.
We have a motion and a second. Any more discussion upon this motion before we vote on it? There being none, I will now entertain a vote on this. If you will, signify by raising your right hand. Okay, that's 7-4, all opposed. That's 1. It passes 7-1. Thank you very much. Tracy, you did a